Consequently, in the present case, once the facts of the case are looked into, the inevitable conclusion is that petitioners were conscious of this fact that they are entitled to fill 50% of the sanctioned seats on their own by holding an examination at state level by the group of minority institutions spread over the entire state, and 50% seats were liable to be filled under common entrance test that has been so prescribed, but at no point of time there has been any leverage or liberty accorded to the petitioner's institution for filling up the unfilled seats required to be filled through common interest test. The petitioners in the present case admittedly have transgressed and overstepped the limit of quota that was prescribed to be filled up by them. Once petitioners are responsible for creating such a situation, then they have to blame themselves instead of seeking misplaced sympathy before this court that said students should be accommodated. The full bench of this court has already disapproved such actions wherein the managing committee, in transgression and overstepping of its jurisdiction, admitted the students, and the reason that has prevailed is that it should act as a deterrent to other students not to come forward for taking admission and then talk of equity. The petitioners are duty bound to be on the side of the law instead of proceeding to violate the same and then trying to get it condoned on the basis of misplaced sympathy. In view of this, as far as we are concerned, we are not at all condoning the act of the management in proceeding to admit 29 students without any authority of law. It may be true that said 29 students are from the same list from which 50 students have been accorded admission. Once the quota in question has been fixed, then the said quota in question could not have been exceeded and overreached, and in view of this, the inclusion of 29 students is totally unwarranted, and the university has acted well within its right in not entertaining such students whose entry in the stream is itself was not backed by statutory provision, rather it was backed by violation of law. We may not approve of various observations that have been made by learned single judge in the decision making process, but certainly the conclusions that has been arrived at by learned single judge are being subscribed by us for the simple reason that once the quota stood exhausted, then the college in question has no authority to admit students even if seat in question was lying waste or going waste. Consequently, in the present case, once the students have been wrongly admitted and have been deprived by the university from taking the B.Ed. examination, then as already mentioned above, we cannot subscribe the illegal act of the managing committee, and the learned single judge is absolutely right in his wisdom in awarding compensation to the said students as admittedly their valuable one academic year has been wasted. Consequently, no interference is being made, but before parting we make it clear that it appears that pronouncement of the apex court is not at all being complete with in its word and spirit and even minority institutions in case they are given liberty to fill up 50% of the seats. The same should not be a localized exercise, rather all the minority institutions will have to come forward under one umbrella for holding of one common entrance test at state level, apart from the common entrance test being held by the state government, and it would be much more appropriate if they join the mainstream as has been directed by the apex court in the case of NEET examinations, Modern Dental College and Research Center versus State of MP 2016. Consequently, challenge made sense merit in view of this present special appeal, and the connected special appeal are dismissed. No order as to cost. Having heard the learned counsel for the parties, the moot question that arises for consideration, for which the court has entertained the petition on a limit jurisdiction, is whether the action of the bank is fair and proper. It cannot be denied that the banks owe a duty to act fairly and in good faith. There has been to be a fair dealing between the parties, complying with their part of the obligations under the contract. The Securitization Act cannot be read to be a one-sided affair, shutting out all possible and reasonable remedies to the other party, namely the borrowers, and assume all drastic powers for speedier recovery of the loan amount. Possessing more drastic powers calls for exercise of higher degree of good faith and fair play. The petitioners cannot be left remedies in case they have been wronged or subjected to unfair treatment, violating the terms and conditions of the contract. It is only on this limited purpose that the court has entertained the writ petition to judge the fairness of the action taken by the respondent bank.